Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and I'm talking about lip filler today, and we were asked, how much lip filler should I get? A very common question. Lip fillers are common. Understand, when we talk about volume of lips, this has evolved through the ages. If you look back to Egyptian times, no one cared about the lips. It was all about the nose and big eyes. And then if you go to Roman times or Greek times, it was all about symmetry. Fast forward today, and it's about size. In the 80s, it was the big wide smile with the teeth, and now size. So how much should you have done? So we're gonna go through four facts about the volume of lip fillers and how much we do. The number one is, the average that people do when they walk into the clinic is still one vial. The reason for that is not necessarily expense, because if people see the result they're going to get, they're willing to buy a few vials. But from an injector's point of view, we like to put in one vial, because if we put too much, the tissue is under a lot of tension. A larger lip can take more volume more easily, but a small to medium sized lip, we don't want to put two or three vials in that lip, because when it's under tension, a few things happen. One is, you get more side effects, lumps and bumps. The arterial supply or the vascular supply of the lip can be affected. And patients like to do a graduated scale if they have a small to medium lip. So not a lot of people notice this huge difference right off the bat. Number two is that lips evolve over time. So when people start with a small to medium lip, and that's a lot of who are coming into our clinics because they want larger lips, of course, we can start with one vial and we move them up over time to a second vial and then a third and a fourth. And how that happens might be 1 month apart, it might be 4 to 6 months apart. It's between the provider, the doctor, nurse, and their patient. But one thing is for certain, there's a continuum. So if you watch people get their lip filler, they'll get a vial, they'll have a nice medium-sized lip, and they add sequential vials. And then you can't really tell if that's going to be 3, 4, 5, or 6, because people metabolize it at a different rate. And some people's mucous membrane, where the filler goes, accepts the product better than others. So your injector will guide you along, because as we're putting the filler in, we feel and we can see the tissue under stress and tension, but you can see a continuum of lip filler to get to the end point. The third point is, people often use their friends as a guide to tell them how much filler they've had in their lip. They'll ask their friend, where did you go? Which is a great question. It's the best way to find a great injector. But they'll say, well, I like your lips. How much did you get put in your lips? And the answer will almost always be, boy, I don't know. I'm not sure. I had one vial here. I had another couple of vials here. I had a few vials last year. And that's the way it goes. People add and top up for different events in their life. When they look in the mirror, they feel like it's going away. When the timing is right to get lip filler, because they can deal with some of the side effects and various reasons. But you'll find people who get lip filler get sequential amounts over time, and no one actually remembers exactly how much they've had. They often have to go to their injector. When I'm looking through the chart, they'll often say, when's the last time I was in here to have it done? And time goes quick, and sometimes it could be a year to two once the lip gets to where people like the size. So it's a continuum, and no one actually remembers how much vials or how many vials they've had in, because of those reasons of metabolism, style, and how they're feeling at the time. The fourth point of lip filler volume is, we always recommend purchasing two or more vials and having two sessions in your mind. And there's many reasons for this. One is, of course, people's perception of what they want changes over time, and certainly not towards the smaller size, but it's almost always towards adding a little more. When you have that second session already pre-purchased, you can plan out what you want to do. Not only is it just getting size, but it's really much more important about the shape of the lip. And once you get the volume added, then we can talk about lip lining, where we don't want to add too much, or you get too much projection in that trout pout. Also, the philtrum columns. A lot of people like to add a little more at the philtrum column. The edge of the mouth to lift it up a little bit. That plays a big role because people perceive you better if the mouth is pointing a little upwards and people are happier. There's a big psychological effect, and also we lose fat down here and the muscle becomes hyperactive. So when we think about lip filler and how much we're using and how many sessions, it's not just the lip, but the perioral region. And no one fills the lip without thinking of the chin projection and that A and E line. And you can watch my videos on that. But paying attention to where the lip projection relative to the nose and the chin is important. So even if you have a little bit of that bile left over for your second session and you're happy with the lips, adjusting the chin and adjusting the Cupid's bow, and you can watch my video all about the Cupid's bow on this channel as well, gives you extra volume to add. So think about two vials to start, one at one session and one on your touch-up session. So there you have it, that's lip fillers. If you have any comments below, we'd love to hear what your thoughts are. How do you do it? How many vials have you had? Join us on this channel and subscribe for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.